So I ball, man, like every day. For all the time nobody helped me, said I ball on you, man, like every day. For all the times you say it, man, I ball, man, like every day. Until the day I pass away, I say I ball, man, like every day. Man, like every day.
I used to burn CDs and pass them around. I used to email the venues and ask them if I could be opening act for the rappers that's passing through town. I used to be the one kids in my city was laughing about. I used to envision everything happening now. I used to ride the bus and listen to Kendrick Lamar. He just liked the video that I made back when I started to study his bars. I'd like to think that he probably related to someone that's come so far. To someone that wanted it badly, then when it got it and turned to a star. Overly dedicated, a title that resonated. I wanna be recognized, I wanna be decorated. Truthfully, back then I couldn't imagine a life where I never made it. Go ahead and let him hate me.
Back in week 11, the Vikings lost their last matchup against the Lions. Can Detroit do it again? The answer comes your way next.
22 men ready to do battle. It's time to dance. And we are underway from Ford Field. And he opts to not bring this one out. The first drive will start at the 25. So here's the Viking offense making their way out. Leading them out from Texas A&M at quarterback, Kellen Mond.
And the numbers were not pretty. I mean, they don't look right. When you throw two interceptions, no touchdown passes, there's no way to really make that work. But I thought there were a lot of positives in watching his game tape. I think he's close to putting out a good performance. Let's see if he can flip those numbers around in this game. And, of course, rally his team to a win.
Flush to his right. And he'll take this beyond the line of scrimmage as he slides to a halt. 4 yards the result on the first play from scrimmage. Second down. Now Mond. Throwing left side here, and it's complete. These are his numbers from last week's contest. 6 catches, 79 yards.
And he's able to pull that last pass in, but this is usually a pretty tough unit to try and maneuver against. They're in the top 10 in the league against the pass, and you and I both know there's not much difference between 1 and 10.
Now the first carry for Dalvin Cook. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50.
Well, there's plenty of real estate for him to maneuver on that run, and let's face it, it shouldn't be a surprise. He's one of the better backs in the league. Had to come into this game with the idea, slow him down, otherwise it's going to be a long afternoon.
And he's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down. Now this defense for the Lions, they were terrific last week in the win over the Rams.
And no matter what's done throughout a ball game, it always comes back to blocking and tackling. That's the essence of football. But I think it's hard for people to understand just how difficult it is to tackle, especially open field. Very few missed tackles on tape that I saw last game. This team does a nice job of getting their opponents on the ground.
Could be 4-down territory even if they don't get this, but they need just a few inches here on third. They'll run it. Here's Cook. And Cook was fighting for it, but I don't think he got there. They'll be marked inches short. No gain on the play, and that's going to lead him to 4th down. And this one is no good. He missed it. And this will remain a scoreless game. That opening drive looked good for a moment there, but they'll wind up being turned away thanks to the missed field goal.
And those especially hurt when you come into a game on the road. You're trying to get things to go your way early, and now you suffer a setback right out of the gate.
Detroit's offense ready to take over. And they, if you just look at this game, Charles, on paper, they've got the edge, no doubt. They're hanging around the top of the NFC. On the other side, you got a squad that's towards the bottom of the NFC. But when we mentioned that to the coaches, they were having no part of it.
Yeah, and I like how you said when we mentioned it. In fact, I mentioned it, and I upset them a little bit, didn't I? Because they wanted no part of that one, and I was reminded, like a 5-year-old, this is the NFL. Any given Sunday, anything can happen. They're guarding against the upset.
6-yard pickup brings up second and
off play
four.
Action. Curran. Dancing to his left. Nothing open downfield, so he'll throw it away.
Well, I like that right there. Not only was it the right play, throwing it away like that, frankly, I think it was the only play.
Yeah, got outside of the pocket, realized he had nothing, just chucked it free.
Yeah, lived to fight another down, right?
He finds his man complete. It's Alvarado, and he's going to have a Lions first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. So first and 10 now from the 30. Off the play fake. Curran. Throw left side complete. That's Wheeler. Touchdown, Detroit. A great effort there. Touchdown number 15 on the year. And the Lions are going to take a first quarter lead. Extra point by Blankenship is up and good. And that makes the score 7-0. So after the touchdown, here's Blankenship kicking off. This will come out to the 25 as Lewis is going to opt to not return it. The Vikings offense making their way back out. And let's give you a look at the playoff picture coming into the weekend in the NFC. And with a final fortnight of games upon us, teams jockeying for position. Some of these games really starting to take enormous importance as they always do this time of year.
I like how you use fortnight.
Yeah,
I am impressed. That means 2 weeks, if I'm not mistaken.
Correct.
But how about exactly what you're talking about? Going down the stretch, how much importance is placed on these games? Look, everyone's talking about every game's important. When you get to this time of year, maybe that importance gets quadrupled. And that's where we are right now, to see who can make their last run, their last push to get into the playoffs. I know many people like to throw to the tight end, maybe in a little flexed out position because he creates mismatches with his size. The slot receivers do the same thing with their quickness, their speed, and their route running savvy.
He's able to force his way through one man, but he can muster only about a yard on the play, second down.
Typically, we think it's the strong safeties that are better tacklers, especially closer to the line of scrimmage amidst traffic. But in this case, how about the free safety coming up and making the big time play?
On second and 9, Mon, and complete right side to Cook. And down he goes at the 49, a 3-yard pickup.
Boy, that was certainly well-read defensively. And the key to any screenplay is space to work. And there was nothing to be found there. And a tackler for just a short gain.
Here's Mon. He's going to float this one deep right side. And this is caught inside the 5. Touchdown, Vikings. Antonio Callaway, his first touchdown on the year. And the Vikings are an extra point away from tying this thing up. The extra point splits the uprights. And that will tie our score here in this opening quarter of play. Sometimes you just got to marvel at how these guys can throw the football. He gave that everything he had, and it was right on the money.
And you think on third down, they'd just be looking for something right beyond the sticks. And I think they caught the defense flat-footed as a result, because they decided they were going to take a shot right there, and it ended up being a big play.
And the final number of the next-gen stats, that ball traveling a full 59 yards through the air. The Lions offense heading out as we give you a look at the playoff race coming into the weekend in the NFC. And right now they're in that number 2 spot. They would love to hold on to that, but obviously first things first, they want to clinch the division.
And that's what everyone plays for. Win your division first, guarantees you a spot in the playoffs, but still a nice spot to be in. Not as good as it was when the number 2 seed meant a first round bye. That's all changed with the new playoff system, but still a nice spot to be in.
And he gets this one just shy of the 40, down at the 39. Second quarter action now from Detroit, and it's the homestanding Lions who have the football. 7-7, our score after one. On first down, Holiday. That one good for 10 yards. And that'll bring up a second and just about a few inches here. Back to throw, Curran. That's caught by the big tight end, T.J. Hockenson. And this is going to turn into another first down as the tackle is made at the Vikings' 27-yard line.
His position, and he's listed as a tight end, but he certainly doesn't run like one. And that's what we're seeing more and more coming into the league. Those guys who can run, make plays after the catch, and gain that additional yardage.
And using that speed there to turn it into a pretty nice little game. And he'll go down right on the edge of the red zone following a pickup of about 7 or 8.
Brings up 2nd and 3 at the 20-yard line.
Off play action, Curran. And that's out to the flat for Swift. Pulling a gain of 3 on the play. And that's going to make it 3rd down and less than a yard.
I know it was a gain, but you have to sense probably a little bit of disappointment there, because when it's out there in open space, I think they expect to get more out of a play, don't you?
Especially when you're getting it to your guy out of the backfield. You're expecting him to be able to create something, be a little more shifty.
Yeah, no doubt about it. Good open field tackling held it to an okay gain.
Throwing on 1st down, Curran. His pass caught at the 4. And in for the Lions touchdown. A great play there. His 5th touchdown now on the year. And the Lions have taken the lead. Extra point by Blankenship is up and good. And that makes the score 14-7. So after the touchdown, here's Blankenship kicking off. This will come out to the 25 as Lewis is going to opt to not return it. And now out comes Minnesota. You know, in our research packet this week, prepping for the game, so many articles from the local beat writer about the offensive struggles of this team and what will they do this offseason. What do you think they'll do?
Well, number one, they'll turn to their self-scouting report. And every team that's any good does this. They have outside groups check out their team, scout them, and tell you who can play, who can't play, and reasons why. Some of it may just be health. They have to get some guys healthy and back out on the field. But overall, evaluate this squad and make the changes that you need to.
So following the incompletion, here's 2nd and 10 from the 25.
Mond going to throw it.
And his throw is going to be incomplete.
So far on this drive, they've done some good work. They force incompletions on 1st and 2nd down, bring up 3rd and 10. That brings up the big question. Do they bring pressure or do they play coverage on this down?
Mond looks to throw.
That's complete to the receiver, Thielen. And he's going to be stopped here a few yards short of the first as the tackle is made at the 33. The Vikings send out their punter as he's on a punt for the first time this afternoon. And just a single punt for him in the loss last week as he sends this one away. We'll call that a punt of 54 yards, well struck. And the Lions are going to take over with a long field ahead and a 1st and 10. Now we get a peek at the captain of this offense heading back out there. And he's been good. 2 first-half touchdown passes, no interceptions so far.
Does a lot for your confidence, does a great deal for your team, gives them a lead, and they're feeling really good about how they're playing. I think he expects to throw at least another one.
I was going to say, now he wants the first-half hat trick, doesn't he?
Oh, without a doubt. Go ahead and fling him on the field, folks. He wants that type of celebration.
On 3rd down, Holiday. And he'll be taken down, but he does have 1st down yardage. Now after the running play, we've got a man down on the field. We'll check on his status when we get back. They'll run on 1st down. Holiday, and he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. 2nd down. Now a handoff here to his running back, and this will be a gain of 5 as he gets it to the 30. We've hit the 2-minute mark of the 2nd quarter, 14-7. And we'll remind you that coming up at halftime, we'll join Jonathan Coachman and the gang in Orlando. Coach will have stats and scores from the early games going on here around the NFL. Toward the sideline. Did he keep the feet in? Yes, he got them both down, says the side judge. And that's good enough for a 1st down. A big play there for Detroit.
Well, partner, that's how you make a long drive suddenly not so long anymore. One big play, and they're already in field goal range with designs on getting more than that.
On first down, Holiday. And he'll fight his way down right around the 12. The excellent play last time is followed by a much more routine gain of 3. The last run got 3. Now here's 2nd and 7. Looking to throw. Curran. Finding his safety valve here. That's complete. And he'll be brought down this time at the 5-yard line. That'll go for a gain of 7. And that'll bring up what looks to be a 3rd and inches. Can't be more than a half a foot.
Well, they're currently the best in the NFL converting on 3rd down, so it was no surprise there that they picked that one up.
And they've done it in many different ways throughout the season, Charles. And he's going to take it in for a Lion touchdown. A great effort there with touchdown number 29, too short of LaDainian Tomlinson's all-time record 31. And the Lions go nearly the length of the field and finish it off with 6 points. Extra point by Blankenship is up and good, and it's now 21-7. So after the touchdown, here's Blankenship kicking off. This will come out to the 25 as Lewis going to opt to not return it. Here the Vikings now to start their next drive. And with him down 2 scores, you wonder if they might try and put something together, even if it's just to get into field goal range. Mond's throw complete to his receiver, Thielen. And he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39. Now after the completion, we're going to get a timeout, an injured player. Well, he gets attended to. We'll step aside. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a 1st and 10. They'll look to throw. And the Lions pressure too strong. Down he goes. Second and 15. Another try after the 1st down sack. Mond. Looking right sideline, but it's incomplete. And now following the incomplete pass, we'll get a timeout here for an injured player. While the trainers take a look, we'll step aside. An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on 3rd down. This time they stay on the ground, and they'll indeed stop him on 3rd down. And now what do you want to do with your timeouts? The Vikings send out their punter as he'll punt it away for the 2nd time. Officially, that'll go as a 52-yard punt. Not too shabby. And the offense will come back out deep in their own territory. A look at the running back, the man out of the backfield as he gears up to go again. We're in the 2nd quarter. They've got the lead. The lead, though, not so much because of the ground game, because of their air attack, Charles.
So what they're seeing so far is...
They've got his man complete! And he is down deep into Minnesota territory. The Lions quickly now going to use the last of their timeouts as it'll come with 15 seconds to play in the 1st half. Inside the red zone here, they'll look to throw. Touchdown! That's caught. A great play there in the final seconds of the 1st half. And the Lions would extend their lead here just before halftime. Extra point by Blankenship is up and good. And the lead now to 3 touchdowns in 21. So not much time to speak of remaining in this 1st half as the kick's away. And Yeah, not wanting to risk anything here late in the half. He'll just take a knee, and they'll bring the football out to the 25. Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. And with 10 seconds left, not really enough time to put something together.
Well, they're just going to run it here up the middle.
And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line. And with just 4 seconds left in this first half, a timeout call. They'll throw now on the final play. And this is incomplete. So we've come upon halftime here in week 7. And okay, so much for our halftime break. Apparently we're going to get right back to it. Okay, Coach, thanks as always to you and the gang in Orlando as we welcome everyone back in for quarter number 3. The final 2 quarters of the NFL regular season are upon us as the second half of week 17 is underway. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24. And as this offense makes their way back out, NFC playoff race time, we give you a look at what's going on there. Now, the first half definitely went their way, and this would seem to be a great opportunity to kind of put this game a little closer out of reach with a score here.
Yeah, and it's a wonderful opportunity for them because if they can add 7 more to their lead before the other guys even see the football, that could be the decisive blow in this game. I think that's how they're eyeing it. That's how they're approaching it.
And they're going to speed things up here. They go play action here on first down. And this one's incomplete.
Well, these two division rivals, the schedule maker gave them a couple of second half meetings this year. They met for the first time back in week 11. And it was the Lions who got the road victory in that one. So they'll be looking to claim the season series now here at home in Detroit.
And oh, he took that in one-handed. What a grab. So the big play has him all the way down to the 30 now for first and 10. Eluding the pressure right. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
Oh, that's got to frustrate him a little bit because I nearly got to him there and it would have been the first sack of the game instead. They're able to influence the release and they did force the incomplete pass.
Here now is 2nd and 10. Back to throw again.
They'll find Dobbins out of the backfield.
9 yards, and that leaves him just short, so it'll be 3rd and less than a yard. And with that last play, he's now up over that 300-yard mark.
And in today's NFL, it almost feels routine. And I hate that when you talk about a 300-yard passing game. To me, 300 yards still signifies excellence, and he's achieved that in this performance.
So 1st and 10, and if they score on this drive, might have to start digging in our second-half blowout material.
They'll keep it on the ground. Holiday. And they'll get him down right around the 16. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be 2nd and 8. And he'll give it here to his running back. And stopped a few yards shy of the goal line at the 3.
62 yards rushing for him now as he's carried it 13 times.
They'll try and run for it on 1st and goal. And just a short gain that time as they're able to get him down. Now after the running play, we've got a man down on the field. While the training staff takes a peek, we'll take a break. On 2nd down now, Holiday, and he's in for the score, and his spectacular season continues as he ties the NFL touchdown record.
He is phenomenal.
Extra point by Blankenship is up and good,
and that'll increase their lead to 28.
So after the touchdown, here's Blankenship kicking off. This will come out to the 25 as Lewis going to opt to not return it.
It's the Vikings' turn on offense. We get ready for their first possession of the second half. They are right now just ice cold. I mean, they have struggled big time in this game, and they're getting blown out. How do they adjust?
So tough, because we always talk about it being a team game, and you need all 11 working well together. But every now and then, partner, you need that one guy who can make a play against all odds that maybe can ignite things. And I think that's what they're looking for right now.
Yeah, you talk about going to your playmakers. They probably need to do it.
Find someone that you're used to touching the football that makes big plays and give them that opportunity.
And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. It'll go in the books as a 7-yard loss on the sack, and it's third down.
So one quick, easy analysis about why they've struggled so far. They keep putting themselves in third and long situations. They just took another sack right there.
And the offensive film session tomorrow may be a little longer than it normally is.
Not a lot of positive grades will be handed out thus far.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. He's going to float this one deep right side. He's got him in. Complete. Touchdown, Vikings. Antonio Callaway, 79 yards. And the Vikings are able to cut into that deficit.
And that looked almost to be a case of, you know, a quarterback saying, hey, I'm going to throw this as far as I can and hope you run under it. Mission accomplished.
And that is absolutely demoralizing for a defense, because you've got the offense on the ropes. It's third down. You're trying to get off the field and then wham. You have a letdown in the secondary, and you give up a big one.
And the final number on Next Gen Stats, how about this? 71 yards through the air.
Extra point right down the middle, and that'll cut the lead back down to 21.
Now Joseph tees it up to kick off following the touchdown. From a yard or two deep, here comes a return. And he'll be brought down shy of the 20, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone.
The Detroit offense ready to begin their drive. Still operating with a comfortable lead despite the score a moment ago as they begin first and 10. A good start to the drive here as that's caught out on the left side and past the 40 before he's out of bounds.
And while we may be looking at the scoreboard, this offense certainly is not, because they're showing no signs of backing down, even with a 3-score lead here in the third quarter. I think they keep taking their shots. They've seen blown leads happen throughout this league. They don't want to fall victim to it themselves.
The last run good for 2. Here's 2nd and 8. Back to throw. Curran.
And that'll be complete to Dobbins.
And this is going to turn into another first down as the tackle is made at the Vikings 42.
This offensive game plan has just been sensational. I mean, when you think about all the different ways they've gotten their receivers open so far, it's really been impressive. Scheme, design, execution.
On 1st and 10, Curran. He finds his man, complete. That's Alvarado. And he's going to be down at the 35, gain of 7. Off the play fake, Curran. He's going to rifle one deep left side. And that going to be incomplete. Good effort there, trying to take a shot, but it's third down. So the incomplete pass on the last play, and that leads us to a 3rd and 3. Off play action, Curran. Toward the sideline, did he keep the feet in? Yes, he got them both down, says the side judge, and that's good enough for a first down.
There's a 1st and 10 at the 14-yard line.
Gonna give this time to the tailback. And stopped a few yards shy of the goal line at the 3. Back now at Ford Field. It'll be first and goal when we come back. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's and he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Detroit. A great effort there. Ties LT with his 31st touchdown of the year. And the Lions are on their way to a 13th win on the year as they add on to their lead. Extra point by Blankenship is up and good, and that'll increase their lead to 28. So after the touchdown, here's Blankenship kicking off. This will come out to the 25 as Lewis is going to opt to not return it. Now the Minnesota offense set to take over again. And they unfortunately are staring at a mini losing streak developing, trailing here in the fourth quarter. This would be their third straight defeat. Mond looks to throw on first down. Here's Mitchell with a catch out of the backfield. He'll be dropped after a gain of about six across the 30 to the 31. They'll come up now second and four from the 31. They'll set up to throw. It's complete. Javon Wims, the open man. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line.
Well, this game was decided a while ago, and that completion there is going to artificially inflate his passing numbers. So right now, the only one really applauding probably his agent as he thinks about angling for a new contract.
On first and 10, here's Mond. He's going to get this one down to Cook. So the completion good for seven there, and it'll be second down. You got the big lead defensively. You're willing to give him that underneath stuff, right?
And this is why you work on your tackling. Tackle him after the catch, inbounds, keep the clock running. Just go ahead and bleed the game out that way.
From the midfield strike, they'll look to throw. Over the middle, complete. That's Mitchell.
This has to go down as one of the simpler routes in the playbook, but oh so effective. Nice completion there. Keeps the sticks moving.
Mond to the air on first and 10. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And he's going to get this inside the 30.
Well, this game is certainly pretty well over. They can go ahead and mark it in the win column. But as a defense, they don't want to get so soft now that everybody just throws the ball all over the place against them, gets big yardage, and puts points on the board. They have pride, too, on that side of the ball.
On first down, here's Mond. It's caught. Mitchell. And inside the 20 before he's brought down.
That's the third time on this drive that these two have connected with each other. They've got a real rapport going. And right now, it's paying off with big chunks of yardage, as shown by that last play.
First down, here's the run with Cook. And he'll get about three as he's taken down at the 14-yard line.
Not too many offenses want to turn down long drives, but when you're down what they are, they've got to pay it off with some points.
Coming up on second and seven. They're going to look to throw. And he's going to be dropped. Back at the 15-yard line. It's a loss of a yard, so they'll wind up crediting him with a sack, and it brings up third down.
We've been around this league for a while, and many coaches never pull their starting quarterback, almost no matter the situation. In this case, though, I think he's got to make a decision. He's taking a pretty good beating out there.
Yeah, and with the deficit, maybe not wanting to risk an injury. And he's got his man in stride, complete. And the Vikings are going to have first and goal as they try to finish off this drive with 6 points.
With the score where it is, this is probably going to be four down territory if they didn't convert there. But what a nice job of working his way open, making sure he secured the catch, and setting up first and goal.
Just 2 minutes remaining here in the fourth quarter of what has been a one-sided affair. So the Vikings in possession of the football as we get you reset. They've got it first and goal as they look to punch in a late score. They'll look to throw here. And this is caught. Well, they get one back, picking up the late touchdown here, but still down big. And down near the goal line here, they're able to throw it in.
And the key word, quick. Quick hitter out of his hands fast, into the receiver's hands even faster.
And now right out of the two-minute break, we'll get a timeout used defensively with a minute 56 to go. Joseph now to have the PAT. And that'll cut the lead back now to 21. So that one, a pretty time-consuming 10-play drive. And it's polished off by a Viking score. And the Lions are able to cover this one up. The fourth quarter, they felt like they needed the football back. Unfortunately, they couldn't get it.
And I know we brought analytics into the game, and someone has said here that the data says that when a team's expecting an onside kick, 80% of the time, the team expecting it, they do actually recover the ball, which is what we saw here. I just wonder if that number is much more of an anecdotal type of a number. Kind of like when the coaches tell us, well, when you score on special teams, 93% of the time you win the game. I'm still waiting to see that number is empirical.
Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. That one looks like he'll throw here. He finds his man complete. That's Alvarado. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard. On second down, Holiday. And he'll get it here to the 10-yard line.
I have to chuckle to myself a little bit, Brandon, because right now, I could be in that huddle with that offensive line. I know exactly what they're saying. If you call a pass play here, we're going to call a timeout. Run the football. We've got control of this thing. Get him behind us and let's go.
Their time to shine. Yeah, this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down. The last run got 9. That leaves him with 2nd and 1 yard. Now a handoff here to his running back. And this is not going to do it as he stopped at the 2-yard line. On third down, Holiday. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Detroit. A great play there. Standing alone with a new NFL record 32nd touchdown. And the Lions are able to grow their lead. Extra point by Blankenship is up and good, and that'll increase their lead to 28. So after the touchdown, here's Blankenship kicking off. This will come out to the 25 as Lewis is going to opt to not return it. Minnesota now ready for their next possession. Let's just be frank. They're playing for pride at this point.
that's all that's left, because victory, not a chance now. And I can't wait to see how they actually go about doing it, because there are a lot of people watching the body language of the guys on the field now, and if they call plays they want executed, they need to do that and do it really well. Otherwise, there could be repercussions.
We'll see how they handle the waning moments of this one. So the big play moves him all the way across midfield. It's 1st and 10 from the 45. Now Mond. Swinging this out wide here for Cook. And now we're going to get a timeout. Somewhat pointlessly called with 3 seconds to go in a game that's already been decided. Watch 36. One final shot. They'll look to throw. He lets this one fly toward the back of the end zone. And that's going to wind up incomplete. However, we do have a flag down. Let's check in with the referee. So the game will continue for at least one more play.
Cannot finish a game on a defensive penalty. That's why they get one more untimed attempt.
Here's Mond. And a little bit of a consolation prize there. He's into the end zone. Won't win him the game, but they do get the score with all zeros showing.
But some fantasy players are really happy with that score.
The extra point is good, but it only impacts the final score as this game comes to a close. On the one side, if you try to take away something positive from this game, they played to the final whistle, getting the touchdown there on the last play, but still, all for naught.